الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم أما بعد، ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا وقد خلقكم أطوارا. عتاب من الله سبحانه وتعالى لهؤلاء الذين سبحانه وتعالى ولا يخافون عواقب أعمالهم، وهؤلاء الذين لا يجلون الله ولا يعظمونه حق التعظيم. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "What is the matter with you? How come you are not in an awe, in fear, when it comes to honoring and the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" And if you know the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you know how little you show gratitude, and how sinful you are, regardless of how much you try to not sin, how come you are not afraid? Why you are so relying on the mercy when you should be worried about what you're doing? Because this is arrogance. كبر. إذا أنت بتكون لا تستحق الشيء وتعتقد إنك ستأخذ. When you think that you deserve something, or rather you're gonna get something, and you know you don't deserve it, this is the arrogance. Just like someone expects people to love him and to revere him and to respect him, and he doesn't deserve it. That is what arrogance is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, given that, I started with this ayah, even though the topic al-khadi'a fi Allah, al-khadi'a fi Allah, how a person can be tricked for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll see. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. Who is Ibn Umar? Son of Umar radiallahu anhu. What's his name? Abdullah. أنت أبو عبد الله، مبسوط أنت على الشيء، وأنا عبد الله كمان. ابن عمر رضي الله عنه is a story about him, but I want to tell you a little bit about ابن عمر. عرف بقوة الحفظ وكثرته، يعني ابن عمر he memorizes a lot and he does it too much. He memorizes the Quran وكان حريص على حفظ السنة. He was so keen on memorizing the hadith. If he is not with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would ask those who were, what did he talk about? What did he do? He was so keen on following the sunnah and adhering to the sunnah to the point he pays attention to everything the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does, to the point that the places when he is traveling where he went to relieve himself. يعني of course some of the scholars يعني said that this is not يعني how extreme you want to follow the sunnah. They may have criticized that, but the reality is he is so adherent to the sunnah, and he reported so many ahadith, 2,330 some hadith reported by Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. كان عابدا ورعا تقيا ذكيا متقنا يعني متقنا لرواية الحديث، وكذلك عنده دقة في الفهم. He reports a lot. He's intelligent. He is very critique when it comes to understanding the hadith and reporting the hadith. And he fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we'll show you how he does that. One thing about him, he was all this good, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one time he made a comment about him. When someone asked about Ibn Umar, asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, سُئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن ابن عمر فقال نعم الرجل عبد الله لولا أو لو كان يصلي من الليل. نعم الرجل عبد الله لو كان يصلي من الليل. what a good man Abdullah is if he prays at night. What does that mean? He wasn't praying too much at night. So this is an indirect invitation for Abdullah to do that. For us, we may receive it differently. يعني هل وقفت كل هالخير اللي بنعمله وقفت على قيام الليل؟ يا أخي بحبش أقوم الليل. أنا في ناس بيحبوش يصوموا وفي ناس يعني some people don't like this or don't like that. But the Sahaba رضي الله عنه they pay attention to the comments of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and they take it to heart. So how good Abdullah ibn Umar is, but he doesn't pray enough قيام الليل. If someone asks you about something, someone, you have to say the truth and the honesty about him. Look what he did. فَلَمْ يَكُنْ بَعْدَهَا يَنَامُ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Very little he started to sleep and he started praying all the time. So كَانَ زَاهِدًا وَلَهُ الْكَثِيرُ مِنَ الْعَبِيدِ. He used to have too many slaves, but زَاهِد. شو يعني زَاهِد؟ يعني ascetic. Or mystic. What is ascetic and mystic? It is a person who criticizes himself a lot, pays attention to himself, يعني his يعني accounts himself too much, and his abstention from indulging in this world too much, especially in religious matters. This is what we call Zahid. يعني Ibn Umar رضي الله عنه, he practiced severe self-discipline. يعني انت مش الحلو مش لازم تاخده. احنا عندنا شبابنا عايشين بهالايام اولادنا اذا حب شغله مستعد يتدين مشان يجيبها. خلص he wants to try everything. يعني انا احيانا بحكي لهم يا طب شو خلي لك شوي للجنه يا زلمه. Our children here, everything they desire, they want to get it. I love cars. So he just has to go and get a car. It doesn't matter how he buys it, how has the money, doesn't have the money, involved in haram, not. He wants to get it. And they look at it, even though they're Muslims and everything, they look at it one life to live. It is one life to live, but live it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for worshiping yourself and your desires. يعني كان روي يعني التابعين او الصحابه الرجال الصالحين انه يعني كان يحب او يشتهي الحلوى المعينه فكان يضعها على مدخل البيت ويمر عنها شو نفسك بدها تاكلها يطلع على حاله يقول والله ما راح تاكليها واطلع. He used to desire some of the righteous predecessors used to desire sweet, certain sweet. So he used to get the sweet and put it at the entrance of the door. And when he passes by, it's like he's dying for it. Then he tells himself, you're not going to get it, and walks out. This is teaching yourself and educating yourself. Because here, nowadays, it seems like, يعني, even with deviant things, the way people look at it, يعني, poor little thing, he's born like that. What is that? He's born like that. So you're born like you love to get drunk. You start getting drunk. Where is self-control? Where is self-discipline? Where is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Where is, I mean, none of that. It's not, yeah. What is haram? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made certain things haram? You desire it. Naturally, you desire it. You like it. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمْعًا. You love it too much. You want more of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't get too much of it. Take some of it and give it. Control yourself. Otherwise, what is Jannah? Look at the hadith. حُفَّةِ الْجَنَّةِ بِيش؟ بِالْمَكَارِحِ وَحُفَّةِ النَّارِ بِالشُّبُهَاتِ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. Nar is surrounded with desire things. So if you want to go to hell, just get all the things that you desire. You go straight to hell. Jannah is surrounded with makarih, things that you like, but you're not supposed to do. So you hate it. That's why it's called makarih. You don't like it. Salah, it's good, But it's hard. Not many people like it in the beginning unless you train yourself. Why? Stop playing. It's time to pray. Ah. You know, you're brother, I just warmed up. We just started the game. Can I stay until the movie is over? Can it's like this salah is going to ruin the desire that you are for. And that is the self-discipline. So Umar ibn Umar radiallahu anhu was like that. So he used to have so many slaves. Look what the slaves do. They take, sometimes people take advantage of your goodness. But look how he looks at it. قَالْ فَيَأْتُونَ وَيُصَلُّونَ أَمَامَهُ. His slaves would come and say Allahu Akbar in front of him. Just like our children when they want something, right? Assalamu alaikum, assalamu alaikum. Baba, كيف حالك? Alhamdulillah, how are you? They're doing good, alhamdulillah. Baba, can I borrow the car? I just want to visit Antonio. So they used to come and pray in front of him. Look why. فَيُعْتِقَهُمْ. يعني it's like they're saying, I accepted Islam. Because when you say tahiyya, you say أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. You entered Islam. So Ibn Umar, إِكْرَام لَإِلْهُمْ, just to reward them, he tells them you're free. So they used to come and do it. Now he doesn't ask, oh, do you really accept Islam? Was that coming from your heart, brother? You know how sometimes when someone comes and accepts Islam, people would come and say, you just said La ilaha illallah. You know, this is, أخي, have some value of the word La ilaha illallah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you say it one time in your life, it will benefit you. You mean it, you don't mean it, that's something not my business or your business to look at it. But Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu saw some of the Sahaba came and told him the same thing. So don't think you're the only one who asked questions like that. فَقَالَ لَهُ رَجُلْ مِنَ الصَّحَابَةِ هَؤُلَاء يَخْدَعُونَكَ. He said, they're tricking you. They're just doing that, so you free them. Now, of course, he doesn't know either. Maybe yes, maybe no. Look at his answer. قال نحن قوم إذا خدعنا بالله إن خدعنا. عيدا. نحن قوم إذا خدعنا بالله إن خدعنا. We are people. If someone tricks us in the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, we get tricked. يعني once we يعني we. We hold Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in great honor and in great love, and we value and know His greatness to the point when someone uses His name, it's impossible for us to think but good about those people. So yes, they're tricking me, it's okay. As long as they're doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will do it. To prove this, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu reported أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال رأى عيسى بن مريم radiallahu anhu رجلا يسرق فقال له أسرقت وفي رواية سرقت. عيسى عليه السلام, he saw a man stealing. He saw a man with his eyes stealing something, it's not his. So he told him, are you stealing or did you steal? يعني it's not a question. It looks like a question, but it's like reprimanding him. How dare you? Look what he said. قَالَ كَلَّا وَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُ. He said, no, I swear by Allah, the one and the only one. وَقَالَ عِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ أَمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ وَكَذَّبْتُ عَيْنِي. He said, I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I disbelieve my eyes. هذا من باب تعظيم الله سبحانه وتعالى وكذلك إحسان الظن بالآخرين. هل في احتمال إنه ما سرقش؟ في احتمال. يعني when he saw, why did he say that? He's holding, يعني he used the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى that he did not. I'm going to tell, يعني عيسى عليه السلام is a prophet. He knows the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He spent his time calling for the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the most knowing and the most fearing and the most loving of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He cannot imagine someone uses the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lying. He cannot see that. How yani when you love someone, it's impossible that you can think other, yani it would be huge. So for him to think that this person is lying is too much. That is one aspect. The other aspect, ihsan Allah. يعني it was reported before, what did one person said, لأن تحسن الظن فتخطئ خير من أن تسيء الظن وتندم. Think good of others and make a mistake, it's better than you think evil of others and then you regret it. يعني you think bad about the brother and it turned out I was wrong. Look how I'm sorry, I don't install, oh Allah, I was thinking but negative, oh my God. Rather, I think good of him, and then I found otherwise. It's okay. You got hasanat, you thought good of the person. This is a lot easier than the other one. Look what Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he critiqued, يعني he made a comment on this hadith, hadith Isa ibn Maryam, he said, والحق أن الله سبحانه وتعالى كان في قلبه أي في قلب عيسى عليه السلام أجل من أن يحلف به أو يحلف به أحد كاذبا. الله سبحانه وتعالى in the heart of عيسى عليه السلام he was more dignified for anyone to ever think that he would swear using his name lying. Even the pagans, they used the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى to conduct their affairs. شو الآية يا شيخ؟ أي سورة؟ سورة النساء. شو الله سبحانه وتعالى قال؟ واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به، يعني تتساءلون به، تقضوا حوائجكم باسمه، بالله عليك اعمل لي كذا وكذا، بالله عليك ممكن تعطيني كذا، بالله عليك سامحني. You use the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى to conduct your affairs and to fulfill the needs between you. So they used to hold the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala great, even the pagans. So Ibn Qayyim saying Isa alayhi salam was doing the same. فَدَارَ الْأَمْرُ بَيْنَ تُهْمَةِ الْحَالِفِ وَتُهْمَةِ بَصَرِ. Now, I saw you doing something wrong. Isa alayhi salam saw him stealing. He swore by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he's not. Now, it's either I disbelieve you, I call you a liar, or I distrust my vision. If I call you a liar and I have bad suspicion and you turn like you are the truthful person, that's bad and horrible and sinful and evil. But if I think good of you and you turn otherwise, it's not bad. You get hasanat rather. And you don't feel. So قال فَرَدَّ تُهْمَةَ إِلَى بَصَرِهِ. So he made a final decision. He accused his vision being wrong rather than the person. So what's the point? What are we trying to catch? We want you to value, hold the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in high. بَعْلَكُمْ لَا تَرْجُونَ لِلَّهِ وَقَارًا فَرْجُوا لِلَّهِ وَقَارًا عَظِّمِ اللَّهِ وَخَافْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَإِخْشَى لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَاعْمَلْ لِلَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَإِنْ خَدَعَكَ إِنسَانٌ فِي اللَّهِ فَلَا تَنْدَمْ فَغَيْرُكَ إِنْ خَدَعَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَرَضِيَ بِهِ. If someone tricked you by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look in a positive way rather than a negative way. Don't say, I cannot believe he did such and such. Say, alhamdulillah, Ibn Umar, I guess, was doing the same. Isa alayhi salam, so I'm on the right path. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.
ما شاء الله. 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 ما